Africa, hello Cameroon, and welcome to yet another episode of Shine Africa. We are at the Somata Hotel in Biemasi, and I say a very big thank you to management and staff of this hotel, and of course to my amazing Shine Africa crew. I am your host, Reverend Abongta Mirabel Seringwa, and on today's episode of the show, we want to talk something that's in connection to football. Fortunately or unfortunately for us, we are talking to a female artist who is very interested and into football, Cameroonian football, African football to be particular. When we come back, ladies and gentlemen, you will meet my guest.
Shine, Africa, shine. Shine, Africa, shine.
So beautiful, so beautiful.
Thank you.
You're so full of energy.
Thank
I love that. When I see a woman doing this, especially in football, It's so wonderful. Now we are going to go to my kitchen, and you asked us to do mango juice, so we're going to do a smoothie. Okay. Please just come to my kitchen where we do the happy juice.
Shine, Africa, shine. Shine, Africa, shine.
Tell me, why do you like mangoes?
I really don't like mangoes like that.
Okay.
But sometimes I have the craving for mangoes. So
okay.
When I was asked the various fruits, I had to go for mango because I'm allergic to pineapples.
Wow.
And I couldn't really see myself mixing mangoes and watermelon. And,
yeah, that's
so
true.
So I decided to go with just mango. I think smoothie would do the deal for today.
That's a healthy and smart choice.
I don't want to share with anybody.
Oh no, just for you and I. We are the stars of the day.
I permit you have it because you're wearing my favorite color.
Ah, so. This is beautiful. Do you have a juice at home?
Yes.
Ah, okay. That's beautiful. It keeps you very healthy.
Yes.
As healthy as you already are. Our juice is now ready. Wow, see the consistency?
Yeah.
Okay, here's for you.
Thank you.
What's your favorite color? You said this is your favorite
peach.
Color I'm wearing.
Yeah.
Ah, okay. So I give you exactly this color. It looks like it.
Yes, it does.
Okay. Let me get the same for uniformity. It's
yeah,
actually
sure.
Not my favorite color.
Well, it's a
now,
coincidence
have a sip
wear
of your juice.
Okay,
please.
Sure.
Mm. How do you like it?
This is divine.
Wow.
This is divine.
You used the correct word. And just before we take leave of you, ladies and gentlemen, remember that a kitchen without a juicer is not alive. A kitchen without a juicer is not alive. Wow.
Shine, Africa, shine. Shine, Africa, shine.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're welcome back from that very juicy break. And of course, you must have discovered that I have a very pretty queen in the house. She's a very pretty queen. I call you queen because you're queen of football. Yeah, I cannot match your love for football. So to me, that's superb.
Thank you.
Are Lady Jayne.
Yeah.
And I must announce, for those who did not realize or those who don't know that song, that's the winning song and, of course, the official song for Shan
2020.
Yes. That's
yeah.
The official, and Shan is the African Nations Championship.
Yeah.
So this is the song that is making waves.
Yeah.
Yeah. And Shan comes before the can.
Of course.
Yes. So this is so beautiful. I'm so happy that a woman could win this.
Thank you.
More to that, a woman from the northwest region of Cameroon.
Yeah.
I'm blushing for you. I'm blushing for you. Congratulations.
It's high time. Thank you.
Yeah. Wow. So tell me a little bit about you. I know that you are Lady Jayne and you're also IHIMS. Just tell us a bit about you.
Okay. I used to go by the name Lady Jayne. But when I went in for the competition, I had a lot of critics because it didn't sound African. Lady Jayne didn't sound African.
Oh.
So I had to go back home
wow.
and pick my family name, which is IHIMS.
Ah, that's your family name?
Yes, and I decided to use it as my artist name.
So where do you come from?
I'm from the Northwest region, and I'm from Benakuma village, precisely, from Menchum.
Yeah, from Menchum.
From
wow,
yeah.
I get it. I get a little lost when you, from Menchum, that brings us back home.
Yeah.
Now tell me, how did it happen? It's from Menchum. Did you grow up here in Yaoundé?
No, I grew up in Tiko.
So how did you get into the competition?
Okay, a few weeks after I I got myself registered as an artist under the Delegation of Culture in Boya. I had a message sent to me from the delegation with the communique. It was actually the communique of the competition of Shan.
Wow.
And when I got it, it was like 2 days to the end of the competition. So I felt discouraged. But I also have people around me who push me a lot. So they encouraged me to take the leap of faith. I did with the help of my team, and we managed to put this song together. And when I went to drop this song, reaching the delegation of sports, they had closed. And I almost collapsed. Like, I've not slept in 2 days trying to do this song, and you guys are closed for the day. And I called back, I went back to the Delegation of Culture, and I said, okay, this is what I've done, but I went there and it's closed. And they're like, okay, this is Friday, but since the communique reached Boya late, you guys have just 1 day of grace, so tomorrow you should bring it. Then I brought it on the next day, and I only got the call that my song was shortlisted among the first three out of the, I don't know how many people contested. So it was actually a song that when I did it, I knew within me that it meant something, because if you listen to it, it's not all about Cameroon. We already know how Cameroonian songs sound, more Bikutsi, Makosa, or Afropop. But there is a little bit of South Africa in it. There's a little bit of Congo in it. So when I gave when I was called for this song, I came to Yaoundé, and I was like, They were like, okay, this song is good, but you have to change your name. Wow. That is how it started, because the Lady Jayne followed the song. And they were like, you have to change your name, because this name doesn't represent Africa in no kind of way. So I said, okay, it was a tough one for me. You know, I was already putting stuff out there, my pages and everything, bore the name Lady Jayne, and now I have to move.
Yeah,
from change
everything,
else.
Yeah.
Yeah, so... Well, I did, and as God will have it, I was the winner for
wow.
the song.
Wow, let us clap for her again, please. Can we clap for her, please? I think she deserves it. You really deserve it, because sometimes when you come from the minority areas and you can quickly win something like this in Cameroon, we shouldn't take it for granted. And considering the fact they had not seen you, and all of that, and you just won. Do you have an idea of how many, of where the other three people, the other two people came from?
One person was a group with a popular Makosa artist of back in the days, who went by the name Tondombe.
Okay.
And the other group was a collective of a Guy Michel, Gael. Wow. Amambiag and some other people.
Did you ever meet at any time in Point during the competition? Was there a concert, a place like this one for you people to present and then be selected and all of that?
Yes, when we were shortlisted, we were invited. The finals were supposed to be on the four. The finals were for the 14th of December, 2019. Yes, so we met. For the rehearsals, we didn't have the same scheduled times, but we always met. And for the finals too, we were all present in the same VIP hall room. And yeah, we got to talk a little bit. But I felt kind of isolated, because nobody knew my name.
Oh God.
They didn't know me. They've never heard of me. But I think within them, there's that connection. They know themselves.
Yeah, they were talking and laughing.
Yeah.
And you were all alone.
I was not in any group or collective. So I was just alone. Somebody, most of the time, I would just be like myself. And they really sing good. So it was
afraid.
A mixture of, yes, frustration, fear, anxiety.
Oh God.
And sometimes in my heart, I would just say, I'm not sure how we know. Go ahead, already know their voice. Like, okay, but you know, the decision didn't come from them at the end of the day.
Yeah.
So, yeah, because when the competitions were going on, I was the last person to perform. So when the first person went, when the first group went, the board, the ratings were already, you know, going
wow,
up.
Wow. Okay.
And the second person, I already saw one person having 65%, person with 30-something percent, and I had not even performed yet. And my heart was beating. But at the end of the day, I don't know what happened, how it happened. I ended up with 83%, 89%.
Wow. Congratulations. So, congratulations. You. Now, before we go on break, tell me how you feel now. I mean, were you an artist before then?
Yes, I was.
Do you have other songs in the market?
Yes, I do. I have one song out, yeah, and I have a couple of songs which I programmed for 2020.
Released.
Yeah, before the Shan thing came in and then just cut
so
everything short.
So before the Shan competition, you had just one song?
Yes, I did.
So tell me, this other song, the second song you did, just took you up. How do you feel now?
Well, I feel very happy. I would not even, miss my words about that. I'm very happy. I've met people that, anyway, from young, I've always loved football. When I was in secondary school, I used to play football. Yes, I used to be a tomboy. So it was really an honor to, do this thing. And then now I can, express my love of football in music, and it's a kind of accomplishment for me. Yeah.
Do you have a financial backing?
We're still hoping on that one.
We're going to talk more when we come back from this musical break, ladies and gentlemen, with IHIMS.
Shine, Africa, shine. Shine, Africa, shine.
McCoy, the wild ass producer.
Growing up as a child, everything I wanted, I had. I go to play me for my ring, cause I don't say nothing, no day for my head.
Look my face, now I don't need a coolie. My head deep, I pull it.
Wow.
Shine, Africa, shine. Shine, Africa, shine.
Let's keep clapping, please. IHIMS, you're so much energy.
Thank you.
And I think that after the song, everyone was echoing everything that you did. I think that you're going to go places.
Thank you.
The break, I like to talk money. Don't mind me. Yeah. I am an entrepreneur, so anything I see is money. So I was asking if this comes with a financial package.
We are still hoping to get to that part yet. That's Cameroon for you. When we were doing the finals.
But they told you that there is a financial package.
Yes.
I don't want to spoil everything for you. So I just want us to know that you don't yet know about it.
Yeah.
Yeah. You're hoping that it's going to come.
Yeah.
Yeah, that is beautiful. Now, I want you to talk to a young girl who is watching at the moment. She's looking at you like, wow. How did she get there? Just the second song. How did it happen? What do you tell them?
Okay, it's not always easy. It's usually, most of the times, it's very difficult. But there is one thing that people always think they don't have, time. But there is also one thing, the time you have is all the time you need.
Wow.
So get up and get pushing. Definitely. It's going to pay off.
Wow, that's beautiful. Tell me, somebody wanted to clap to that? Okay, let me do it. I saw hands coming like this and going back. Okay, tell me about your future projects. After the Shan, it's going to happen here in, where's the Shan taking place? Here in Cameroon, right?
In Cameroon,
right?
Yes.
Yes. So you're going to perform live?
Yes, opening and the closing.
Yeah, so... After that, what other prospects do you have for yourself?
After that, I'll be dropping Derangé.
This one you just did?
Yeah.
Oh, this was an exclusive.
Yes.
Oh, thank you very much for doing that on Shine Africa.
It was an exclusive.
Yeah.
I'll be dropping Derangé, and then I'll be doing Heart, which is a song that it's a pinch of me.
Wow.
I'll be doing Heart, and after that... In fact, the whole of this year is going to be juicy from my end.
Wow.
I'm just going to give it to you guys hot, hot, hot.
That's a beautiful way of saying it. In your song, I got too many things. I got the hustle. I got you being a woman and, I mean, a female artist.
Yeah.
As beautiful as you are.
Thank you.
What are some of the challenges you're facing?
Of course, we all know.
It's obvious.
I don't think that those are things that should be asked anymore. We just have to put them like in our guideline. Okay, if I get up in the morning, I go to an office. Okay, this has to happen. When you're giving your file, you have to put this in. You know, we don't have to ask it anymore like a question.
So how do you handle all of that?
Well, you as a woman or as a human being, first of all, I would like to start by saying I decided to go by the name Lady Jayne because I feel like a lady cannot be pushed around.
Wow, beautiful.
Yes, so even though I don't use the name anymore, but it's still me.
It's still you.
Yes, so I manage that by standing my ground. I might need something from you, but I'm not going to be desperate about it.
Yeah, yeah.
Because either ways... I'm going to get it.
You're going to get it. Wow.
Because I'm a lady. Yes.
That's the woman I love, the African woman that I want us to be.
Yes.
Yeah.
And I always try as much as possible to be nice and soft-spoken because we women, our problem is right
yeah,
here.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So you can talk anything out of anyone. And I also have the attitude of gratitude.
Wow, like this is beautiful. Even, the attitude of gratitude.
Yes. Even in the law of universe, if you want to get anything from anyone, you should be able to appreciate that person. There's no way you get into a palace, you praise the chief, you lie on the floor, and you leave that palace empty-handed.
That's true.
So when I get into somewhere, I always make everybody know that I'm under them. Yeah. So, we all have conscience.
You always just get what you want.
Yes.
Yeah. Until that point when you can sufficiently get everything you want by yourself.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think it's very important, and that if we had some more time on the show, we would be talking a lot and lot of things that you can teach the Cameroonian woman and also the African woman.
For sure.
Now, a lot of people have been listening to you, especially people who are in this hall, and probably they have questions for you. It is the audience question.
Shine, Africa, shine. Shine, Africa, shine.
Hi, I'm Bitron Fongso from the Living Legends Empire. Already, congrats for what you're doing. My question is this.
Thank you.
For how long can you stand if things get rough and difficult in music? How much is the passion?
Well,
How strong is it?
Okay, first of all, music for me is not really a passion, it's a lifestyle. I didn't start music today. I started singing when I was 5 years old. I composed my first song at the age of 6. I've been in choirs, I've been in groups, I've been a backup singer, and I decided to stand alone. So even if it gets rough at one point, like I said, I'll keep pushing. That's the only thing I can do, nothing more.
Wow. That's the only thing that everyone does anyway. Yeah. So this is the time where you ask me a question. It is the guest question.
Okay. All right. I know that you're a pastor.
Yes.
And I know how we are sometimes. So how do you cope with, dealing with this show and the church, considering the fact that we do secular music on this show and you have to dance too? So how do you come across people, and then how do they react with you being a pastor, not just a member, handling both personalities? Mm-hmm. How do you overcome that?
It's like asking God why he is God and creating the world, making some people are bad in the world, some people are good in the world. Some people are Muslim, some people are Christian, some people are Buddhist. We are not living in heaven. We're still on earth. In this world, there is still crying, there is laughter, there is everything that we have. And I don't live on a holy street. I'm not sure that all my children are going to be Christian. This is all of God's design. So I believe in going to church. I'm not just a Christian. I'm not just an elder. I'm a reverend pastor ordained. And I believe that it's like, okay, I go to church and tomorrow I'm going to work, because the Bible says there's no food for a lazy man.
Yeah.
And the work I'm going to do is not going to be praying. So I pray on Sunday. On Monday, I go to work. But when you're a Christian, you have a prayerful attitude in whatever you are doing. Yeah. I don't see what stops me from dancing to what you call secular music. I don't call it that way. It's music. The other one is, it's not even gospel music, because the gospels are just three of them in the New Testament. But people sing stuff in the Old Testament. So it's like, it's Christian music. We sing a lot of stuff. And like I always say, I'm just doing what I was called to do. I'm professionally, I have a bachelor's degree in theology, another one in journalism. And so I'm just living my life the way God called me to do it. And I'm impacting lives. Like yours?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, of course, I will not do things like any other presenter would do. There is a lot that I do on my show behind the scenes that you cannot see here. Yeah. You
For
impact
sure.
lives in many ways. That's what makes us different, whether as Christians, as pastors, as Buddhists, or whatever. Thank you. Did I answer the question?
Of course. There couldn't have been any better answer. I got
thank
the share
you.
Of what I wanted.
Thank you very
thank
much.
You very
thank
much
you very
too.
Much. Now is, let me get off that hot seat. I hate this slot, the question slot. So I'm going to my best slot, which is the dance slot. And you asked us to do, what are we dancing to?
We're dancing to my friend Kosi's Mompalapala.
Palapala by Kosi.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Can we have a DJ on that beat?
Shine, Africa, shine. Shine, Africa, shine.
C'est Papa God qui connaît tout. Mompalapala, oh. C'est Papa God qui connaît tout. Mompalapala, oh. Can't you travel to the shine de Papa, c'est Papa God qui connaît tout.
se papa God ki konetu. Bam pala pala o, se papa God ki konetu. Bam pala pala o, kan tu bolo tule tule jande papa. Se papa God ki konetu. Bam pala pala o,
hey, go see. Give me the mic, yo.
Wow. You're a very pretty dancer, I must say. I'm not trying to influence anyone, but she's a very good dancer. That's all I said. So now let's see how many marks she's made for herself just dancing. Was it a five? Was it a... Was it a nine? That leaves us with a 10. That was 10 on 10. Okay, you're not going to sit down anymore. You're going to leave your championship signature and name on the African calabash. Just get any space. Wow. Thank you. She did it right here. IHIMS. That's for verification. Thank you so much. And you're not going back from here without a gift from us, at least. Wow. Here is to you from Shine Africa.
Thank you, Shine Africa. I'm going to cherish this for the rest of my life. It's going to be, this is my second trophy. So I'll just keep it in my trophy shelf. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. And see you some other time.
Thank you very much.
And I must say that your makeup really fits you.
Thank you.
Thanks to our makeup artist, Kujongwa Kate. Wow. Thank you.
Thank you, Kate. Thank you, Shine Africa.
Thank you.
Shine, Africa, shine. Shine, Africa, shine.
Before we take leave of you, ladies and gentlemen, here is our watchword. It is an African proverb which says, the child of a rat is a rat. The child of a rat is a rat. Ladies and gentlemen, we have been at the Somerton Hotel in BMC, and of course we say many, many thanks to management and staff of this hotel, and of course to my amazing crew. I remain your host, Reverend Abongta Mirabel Serengwa. Until next time, ladies and gentlemen, it's a bye-bye from me to you. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.